Before this, I will talk about feature selection also, because again, this problem is one unique problem where we needed some very good features. So we tried traditional TF, IDF. One thing really helped from the psychology perspective, because if you want to separate deceptive and normal reviews, we needed to understand the mindset of people who deceive. So as per some psychological studies, people have figured out that when people use deception or people think to fake, then the kind of part of speech densities they use and the kind of focus on themselves or focus on the company, focus on the hotel properties and all is different. For example, if you let's say really stay at the hotel, you are like the detail orientation is high. For example, like the linen supplied is very clean, or it has a very good balcony, the balcony is cleaned, or food is good. So there's a lot of detail orientation, which is like more of proper noun increment. Whereas in deceptive reviews, people were imagining, so they don't know what actually the hotel offers, right? So they were not very detail oriented, but that means the noun density between deceptive and non-deceptive is less. The second thing is PRP. PRP is the third person pronoun in parts of speech tag. Especially when people talked about deceptive reviews, deception, they were focusing on themselves rather than on the hotel or their services. Positive reviews, real reviews, were talking about services, products and all. Deceptive people were talking about, hey, I felt terrible, I felt very bad, I felt this, I felt that. So many I's. You are focusing on yourself. So the third person pronouns especially had very high density, and it became one of the most common feature in this particular problem. And look at that adjective density also. So again, people who were really staying at the hotel were using less adjectives, but people who were asked to deceive were like, hey, this is disgusting, this is so bad, this is that and all. So that's how, when you look at the psychology perspective, we understood different parts of speech tags, their density in the reviews were the most distinguishing features. And in fact, we have that nouns, adjectives, and PRP, pronouns, density. These three features were actually enough to get up to 84% accuracy. Okay, that's features perspective. Now, once we went to models, I didn't understand the reason, but SVM was performing very good on this particular model. Maybe more of a linear problem, with a lot of less number of features and lot of data samples. That's where the data set looked more linearly separable, and I think that is the reason SVM performed very well. After that, Navebase performed next better. Yeah.